motherfucker.
Okay. Welcome to my garage. We're going to do a radiator change today. And we're going to do a slight little modification. And what we'll need first is a new radiator. This one here is from GPI Racing, located in Melbourne. It's probably all out of China. I notice the bracket mount here is going to need some bending to actually match the original one, but everything else looks a bit alright. And we're going to need a switch. Now this switch is actually, it's semi-waterproof. No good if you submerge it, but will be good as far as rain and weather goes. I've done a couple of different modifications like that in the past. And we're going to change the radiator. So let's get it down here. I've already taken the basic things off. I'm sure there's plenty of videos. Come on, sorry. I'm sure there's plenty of videos out there that show you how to remove the tank and the guards and the seat. This one here, I don't know if you see this down here. The actual radiator switch here for the thermo fan has been broken, and it looks like it's had some hot glue or something put in there. So we'll see what we can do with that. But for a start, we're just going to drain the radiator. I'm just going to take the actual thermo fan switch out and drain it via there. I won't bore you with the details. I'll fast forward through most of this. Just make sure you take the radiator cap off. Actually, one important thing when you do your radiator is check your coolant. As you can see, this coolant looks nice and green. I'm actually going to run a different coolant in there rather than that. Now it is important not to actually just go and pull these straight off, especially if your radiator is in good condition. Just give it a bit of a twist and you'll find it will come loose. Loosening that up by giving it a bit of a twist. Now it's always best to put new radiator coolant in there, but if it's on a weekend or something and you can't get down to the automotive shop, make sure you use a clean bucket and you can reuse your coolant. Now the reason why this particular radiator went is because, yeah, I basically had to drop it. I was going a little bit hard into a corner, supermoto style, come in sideways a little bit, left a little bit too late, and there was a bit of a drop off, so it was either drop the bike or go off the drop off. I'll show you what I mean. for this part here, you can see in there, you've got a 10mm nut bolt in there, and with another 10mm bolt just down here. Do is just look at these connections. There's the no fan connection here. I'm trying to get that apart. It's just a little clip on here. Take that off. Now make sure we take your overflow hose off. And the same again, just a bit of a loosen up. It's as easy as that. Yeah, the reason why I decided to make a few videos is a few of my mates have asked me to make some videos. That way when they can do things, they can just check it up instead of getting me on the phone and going through it step by step. Okay, now what we've got to do is basically take our thermometer. Okay, as you can see, it took me a few minutes, but yeah, I got the thermo fan back on. Now I had to tweak these brackets here just a little bit to make sure that we've got clearance on the radiator, because I had a few little bends in it, and that's what you get when you try to supermoto around corners and you've got Dunlop 6A6s on there. Yeah, they drift good, but at the end of the day, yeah, it's probably not worth it, although it is a hell of a lot of fun. But I can recommend getting some crash bars for the front, that's for sure. Okay, we've got the thermo fan back on. This rubber grommet looks a bit average, but you know, it's gonna hold all right. It'll be a replacement job for another day. So it's just a matter of bolting it back up. And what we're going to do is I'm going to actually put a thermo fan override switch on it, because I noticed, especially when you're doing on a walk, going on a warm day through the forest, you're doing some slow technical stuff, the thermo fan kicks in at just over halfway, but I notice it sort of gets pretty hot, as where when you're doing the slow technical stuff, if you've had an override switch, which will come in here, you can just flick this on and just keep riding and not worry about it. As soon as you get on the open track again, you're doing around 60 kilometers an hour, just turn it off and don't worry about it. Yeah, one thing that I didn't say was this actual bracket here, this one here, this is actually bent down. I don't know, this is like $120 radiator, so as long as it holds the coolant, I'll be happy. This is the original one, so I've just bent it up so it roughly matches, because this one would have been bent a bit anyway. So this was actually hanging down, so I just bent it up. It was pretty easy to bend. I just used a shifter and it bent straight up. So I'm going to use this new radiator cap and we'll see how it goes. Okay, that's basically our radiator installation again. Now it's important to put your actual thermofan switch back in here. I'm just going to have a bit of a tick around with this for a little bit, and as you can see, this one's looks like shit, but yeah, I'll take that bit of hot glue out of there, get the connections going, and probably hit it with a bit of epoxy resin. Okay, so as you can see here, if you can see that, I've actually fixed this up, straightened up the connectors in there, and that feels pretty solid there, but I'll probably get a new one later on, but this one will do for now. These actually got an O-ring on it too, so actually it's very important, just check the O-ring, make sure it's not too brittle, if not, replace it. Otherwise she's going to end up wasting a lot of coolant. So I'm going to do a few more. Not too sure. Yeah. Okay, now one thing I've noticed, this is the original O-ring off the original thermostat switch for the fan, thermo fan. Now this one here is the bolt that came out of it, and this is the O-ring off that. So I noticed when I went to bolt it up, there's a big difference, and all I could see was there's a gap there. So now I'm assuming that you use this one off this here, which comes off the plug which comes with the radiator. But if you have a look there, it looks very, very thick, and to me, if that spreads out, I don't know. I don't feel very safe using that one. I've got an O-ring kit, but that's one thing to look at if you buy one of these cheaper radiators, I suppose. I've got this one here. You can see that this one's a little bit thinner than the one that came with it. So I'm going to use this one because it just fits over here better and just sits in that bottom thread there a lot better. So hopefully this one here is not going to leak. The original one that came with the kit may fit. And it may do the job, I'm not too sure, but I just prefer to use my O-ring, so I've got an O-ring kit, and yeah, that's better. That should give a good seal there, feels like it would anyway. What I'm going to do here is cut this back a bit here, and we're going to get into these two wires here for the override switch. And one thing, when you're working on bikes, you don't need like $3,000 worth of tools. I've only really got a few, I haven't even got a big toolkit or anything. You just need enough to do the job. So don't think you need a shitload of tools just to tinker with the bikes. Okay. What the cows I'm going to do now is just roughly see how long a bit of wire we're going to need. Run that up through there, around here up to, I'll probably run it up here beside my 12 volt power out, I'll leave a little bit more slack. Get enough lengths. When you're routing wires, can actually route them anywhere you need. I'm just going to follow the original loom up and around behind, and I'll come out here and I've got a 12 volt power out up here, so I'm just going to come through the fairing and put my override switch up here, and that way I don't have to worry about it getting knocked off or on. All I'm using is some 3mm 10 amp wire, and I'm just going to put it in here, feed into these two, and then run up to my switch basically. I'm just using a little electrical connector. Let's run those in line and put a bit of electrical tape over that one, but I just want to see if these are going to work for a start. Now, these are some electrical fittings that I had sitting around. As long as they're about the same size, you can see where they clip on. Okay, so we'll just give the thermo fan a test run. Okay, we've got our switch plugged in, got our connections there, thermo fan is plugged in, Yeah. Yeah, we're good to go. Now this down here, this will kick on with your temperature switch, and when you want to go at a bit of low speed, or if you're sitting in traffic on a really, really hot day, and yeah, it doesn't kick on until getting over halfway. If you're a bit fussy like me, don't like my bike getting too hot. I know you can run the thermo bobs and that sort of thing, but I find one of those and you're good to go. It'll be mounted up here, click it on, leave it on, turned off as soon as you hit 50-60 k's, and don't worry about it. Now all I'm going to do now is mark which one goes there, so when I mount my switch I can have it up or down. It really doesn't matter, it's up to you, but I just throw a little texture mark on it so I know where to put in when it fits it up here. Now, as you can see, I didn't have any proper electrical tape, but that's the next best thing. So I just ran the wiring up here, around the outside, up around the frame, and I've come in, and there's my connections there. I'll actually go under here. I've just drilled a hole. It's about I actually went about 12 mil. You probably only need about 11 mil, but that was the next size drill bit I had. Now, if your drill only takes up to 10 mil bits, or your chuck size only 10 mil, you're just going to have to do it 10 mil, and then just get a round file / rat's tail file, and just file the hole out a bit. So I've got that up in there, and now we're just going to put the switch. Okay, now we've got the switch in, it's just a matter of putting it in, and that little waterproof piece has actually got a little brass nut on the end of it, so we put it in now. That'll just sit there beside the 12 volt. Now we've got the thermo fan will kick in if the bike gets too hot, or if we wish we can just turn it on ourselves. And that sits out of the way, it's not going to get in my way anyway. Okay. Now that's about it. All we've got to do now is hook back up the hoses, put your coolant in there, and put the bike back together, and you're ready to go. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye.